Hello. Well, here we are on a chronic morning at Stansted Airport, London. Just, well, getting ready to depart for Milan Bergamo Airport in Italy for a summer holiday. You can see here it's summer in Britain. Pretty normal sort of British weather, but anyway, we're on the plane and ready to go. I'm not going to say too much. I'll say a bit at the beginning. There's some things to say, but for most of the journey, I'm not recording the entire journey, by the way. Just some random highlights that I decided to video from the window. Or is it a porthole on the plane? I don't know. But we got this Ryanair flight. It was okay. You can see here where the other plane is lining up. We had to wait for some of these to go. There's a queue of them up there. We were attracted to Ryanair because of their ostensibly cheap prices. But of course they sting you for everything they possibly can. To make up the difference. I think one of the worst things about their policy is their baggage size limitations. They are deliberately 1 centimetre smaller in size than those of the other airlines so that they can charge you 50 quid per bag to put it in the cabin. I mean, this is nothing, I think, but sharp practice, i.e. dishonest, because they're the same planes with the same size luggage compartments. Maybe they're trying to discourage holidaymakers, or i.e. customers, I don't know. Do they have too many? I don't think so. Although the plane was busy, of course. But in practice, if you check in your bags online, they're not worried about it. Just don't check them in at the airport, and they've got no excuse to measure them, basically. Just a little tip for you. But of course, I would also make sure your bags do fit within their rules, because they're probably experienced enough to spot them by eye if they're too big. We in fact found that we needed to take less luggage than we thought for a 2-week holiday anyway, so it's easy. We were planning to each have one large bag and one small bag, but what we did instead was have one large bag and two small bags, and that was fine. The small bag, You don't have an extra laptop bag or anything like that. No. On the conventional airlines like British Airways, you do. They don't bother about a camera bag or a laptop bag. But on Ryanair, they really do. You could say it's oriented towards business travellers who only will take like an overnight bag and a laptop bag, and that's it. And maybe it's true. Oh, here we go. Taking off is always fun. It's you can feel the power of the plane, and it goes away from the ground so quickly. Metres up, we're into the clouds. Of which, being Britain, there are lots. Anyway, the flight itself was okay. I couldn't understand the announcements they were making. I couldn't even tell sometimes whether they were speaking English or Italian. The microphone sound quality they had was absolutely awful. With a very narrow bandwidth, I suppose, designed to cut through the noise of the plane, but in practice it just made it inaudible anyway. But there were signs all over the place telling you, you know, if a plane's going to crash, stick your head between your legs and kiss something goodbye anyway. So anyway, enjoy the scenery. We're getting through the clouds a bit now. And doesn't it look fantastic when you get above the clouds? And just enjoy the view, and I might have a bit more to say right at the end as we arrive at Milan Bergamo Airport. And maybe a bit in between, there's a bit of scenery on the way, but goodbye for now. guess is we're flying over the south of the Thames and we've turned east, and that may be Gravesend or somewhere like that down there. I'm not sure. Could be Woolwich, even if we're closer into town. Here, though, we are clearly over the north coast of Kent, and there is one of the wind farms. Britain is a windy place. Now we're out over the North Sea, basically, and heading towards Europe.
nostro servizio duty free, abbiamo una vasta gamma di profumi, cosmetici, articoli di regalo, tutti scontati fino al 30% in conversione con i prezzi della profumeria. Abbiamo marche prestigiose come Calvin Klein, Dolce & Gabbana, Armani, Jean-Paul Gaultier, Yves Saint Laurent e tanti altri. Questo mese abbiamo un ulteriore sconto di 10% per tutti i profumi. Ad esempio, Dolce & Gabbana numero 3, la peretrice è solo 35 invece di 39 euro, la Bebe Adon & Co per 49, 50 invece di 55 euro, anche i nostri profumi d'estate Calvin Klein e Tommy Summer per solo 30,60 euro.
If you look closely at this town, when the camera manages to focus, it actually looks a lot like England. It's shaped like England. I wonder where it is. Holland, maybe? I don't know.
started our final descent towards Milan Bergamo for the captain has switched on the fastest possible sign. So please return to your seat if your seat wants to come in fasten. Ensuring our harness is down, 3 doubles on the way with the blind is fully open. There should be no more walking or standing in the cabin aisle. And use of the toilets is no longer permitted. We shall be landing in the next 15 minutes.
Atterraggio, capitano, accese sia le cinture, vi chiamo di tornare al vostro posto, cinture ben allacciate, tavolini riposti, oscuranti e finestrini completamente aperti. A questo momento in poi camminare lungo la cabina o usufruire dei bagni non è più consentito. Terremo in meno di 15 minuti da adesso. Grazie.
Guessing this is one of the lakes in Switzerland, Lake Neuchâtel or Lake Brienz, possibly. I don't think it's Lake Geneva. It might be, I don't know. One of those. I suppose it's possible we're over Italy already. And these could be some of the northern lakes, including perhaps Lake Como where we're headed. Can't really tell through all these clouds, or I can't. Maybe you can leave a comment and let me know, I don't know. This, I think, is Lake Como. That looks like Varenna. So the other one perhaps was Lake Lugano, which is nearby. And that big town is definitely Lecco, where we are going to be staying. So we'll be landing shortly. Thank you.
almeno 100 lente, almeno 100.
Well, perhaps we were flying over Italy already, because clearly here we are at Milan Bergamo Airport. And a fun little flight it was. I feel a bit sorry for the staff on the plane. I mean, they're offered to, you know, to do this glamorous job, and they spend their time selling us chicken nuggets and sandwiches, and then they come around again with drinks. What else was it? Lottery tickets, for goodness sake. You might win £1,000, oh my god. Oh, and some stupid advertising magazines. I don't know. They must get sick of it, but it's a job, eh? But look at this scenery and the weather, of course. A little bit better than blighty. Well, this video terminates in a very short time, so I'll say goodbye for now. Enjoy the taxiing. Bye.